Thank you, madam. It's my honor to be here to share the experience of democracy in China. Now, I'd like to say all democracy is equal, and we are all on the way to democracy. And democracy has not only one model. Now, I would like to share the experience of Chinese democracy from a perspective of rule of law. You know, China is a transitional society. It's still on the way to modernization, and also still on the way to rule of law, and also to democracy. A traditional Chinese society is we can call it a governance based on relation. The Chinese character is guanxi. It's very hard to translate into English. Yeah. Now it's on the way to relation-based governance to the role-based governance, namely rule of law. Yeah. Many Western scholars call Chinese democracy authoritarian state, but it's not right. Yeah, I would like to introduce the some institution of Chinese democracy. For example, firstly, the democracy in legislation. Yeah, in China, all the people can find the any legal document on the internet, for example, the National People's Congress or local People's Congress, and it's very communicated freely. Yeah, and people can give suggestion to the National People's Congress, even where ordinary Chinese people can suggest to the National People's Congress on the internet. For example, if you find out any legal document is unconstitutional, you can send an email to the National People's Congress, and the National People's Congress will review the constitutionality of the legal document. It's very convenient. You can finish all the work on internet, and the National People's Congress will just send you email. Yeah. So if you find if you find some legal draft is on the process, so you can give suggestion to the Congress, and it's open to all the public. And this is a democracy in legislation, and also in the administrative process, it's very convenient for ordinary Chinese people to connected with the public official. For example, the public, you can ask the administrative branch to open the information of their work. And if the public, if the administrative branch refuses this, you can take litigation to the court and to ask the court satisfy your issue. Yeah. So in China, if you want to help to ask for help from the administrative, you can just give a call to the administrative branch. The number is 12345. It's very freely convenient to ask the help. Yeah, and for the judicial procedure, it's also play a very, very important function in the democracy. For example, in China, you can download all the judgment from internet, from the Supreme People's Court, the website of the Supreme People's Court, and also it's freely. You can find the judgment in the website, the download it freely. Yeah, and in China, we have some very special court called Internet Court. You can take actions on the internet, it's very convenient for all the people, and the people needn't go to the court. Yeah, and that's the court. It's a play very important role in the democracy. And also, some Western states criticize the human rights protection of China. But actually, it's not the truth. For example, the people have enjoyed more freedom, more freedom than the Western society. And the truest thing, truly problem is the limitation of the right, not to the protection of the right, because it's China still is on the way to rule of law. And the definition, limitation of the right protection is not so clear, not so exactly. So some people criticize the right protection, yeah, but it's that's not true. And also now, many people, most of the people in the world now, the government of China have just published the white paper, yeah, of the Chinese democracy. It's called Democracy That Works. Democracy is not the last thing of the world. It has some value. For example, the people's happiness, the people's dignity. That's the value, basic value of the society. And the Chinese people call the democracy in China whole process democracy. Yeah. This democracy can satisfy all the people and protect the basic rights of all the people. Why the Chinese democracy called the whole process democracy? The key point is the leadership of the Communist Party. Yeah. The tension between rule of law and human rights, the tension between the rule of law and democracy is a common problem of all the states, whenever Western state or Oriental state. But in China, how to solve this problem? The answer is leadership of the Communist Party. And just because the leadership of the Communist Party, it can avoid the situation of dictatorship of majority and to protect the interest and rights of minority. So the Communist Party is have very complicated institution and organization. In all the government branch, the Communist Party insisted to keep in touch with the people, always keep in touch with all the people in all the process of the governance. So that's why the Chinese democracy is called whole process democracy. Yeah. So that's what I want to say. Thank you, madam. Thank you very much.